Hello, everyone. Santa here, and we're in Bloodstained Ritual of the Night because I want to talk about their food system. This is a piece of design that I think is really interesting. And I'm partway through the game, and I've been enjoying it. And one of the things that I really have been enjoying is hunting for these foods, for ingredients, and cooking. And you can see over there on the right, where it says total bonus, there's a bunch of blue numbers, things going up, all that sort of good stuff. And that's talking about the bonus I'm getting from eating food. So if you look over here on the left, it says consumed on this fried fish that I have highlighted. And it gives +2 int. That is a permanent buff to my character. And if I go down to these scrambled eggs, it says first time bonus, +1 mind. Or, well, that's not exactly +1, but you get the idea. So if I eat these scrambled eggs, my mind stat over there on the side will go up by 1. Scrumptious. See, now I have 11 mind instead of 10. And so this is part of their food system, their cooking system, and it's an incredibly interesting part of it. I really like what it does. So I'm going to go ahead and go to their cooking menu. So they have a whole thing for cooking here, and you can see there's a lot of foods that I've eaten. This spoon and fork icon indicates that I've consumed it. And so what they've done here is they've taken cooking, and cooking in video games is often, like, if it is a thing, usually what it provides is it's basically a healing system, or it's some sort of buff system. So for example, like Guild Wars 2, eating food gives you some sort of temporary buff that after a while it wears off, whatever, it does a thing. And like plenty of other games, I don't have any immediate examples off the top of my head, unfortunately, but food will just be, you pick it up and it's a healing item, or you cook it. Breath of the Wild, actually. Breath of the Wild is a really good example. It does both of these things, where eating food heals you, and it can provide some sort of temporary buff, right? Breath of the Wild does that. Excellent example. So what this game does is you have a cooking system. You have the ingredients, like breads. I don't know why you can't just eat bread. That's a weird... But anyway, beef curries, things that you can cook, and we have all sorts of different stuff in here, right? And different ingredients that you can collect. Enemies drop a lot of these. So, for example, this beast beef you can see is dropped by an enemy. The G-bone steak, the flying beef, these are things that are dropped by enemies. And so they're a random reward that you get for killing stuff, as you would expect. And the way that the system works, then, is you have this first-time bonus. When you eat something for the first time, it gives you that bonus. That bonus, then, adds onto your character permanently, so it's a permanent stat buff. A little bit like a heart container or like a sage or other herb that you might find in some other RPG. I think the Tales of games use some herbs. You can use it on a character, get a permanent stat buff. But it's really hard to have something that's a permanent stat buff or heart container or whatever, something that permanently increases your character's stats, as a random drop. Because then the players can just farm it and make arbitrarily powerful characters with however much time they want to invest in it. That usually introduces some balance problems. And so what they've done is, the other thing with a system like that, actually, that I should highlight, is it incentivizes you to go after the specific things that give you that item, right? And so what they've done with this system is, because different ingredients are needed to make different foods, obviously. Like, these are very similar, right? Beef curry and chicken curry. One requires G-bone steak, and the other requires flying beef. They do similar-ish things. They increase my maximum HP by 50 and another stat by 8. But that's the first time I eat them. Now, the other thing is they will heal me. Like, food in this game is a healing item. It is a potion proxy. And you do have potions in this game. You have healing potions. So I could theoretically, well, not on this menu, but you can see I can make potions, high potions, X potions. There's healing items in this game, ethers as well. But so food does heal you, but it also, the first time you eat it, gives you a permanent stat bonus. And what's really cool about this is it has a bit of an effect on the reward structure. When you find a new enemy, you might be able to get a new ingredient for a new recipe that gives you a permanent stat buff. That allows enemies to, in effect, drop stat buffs. Kind of. The first time it is. After that, it's a healing item, or a component of another recipe for another stat buff, perhaps. So this encourages you to get ingredients to explore the world, to find new enemies, to be able to increase your stats. But you'll also notice the stat buffs aren't massive, necessarily. Ones and twos often, with especially a lot of the stuff I've already done. Some of these are stronger than others. But you can see, like, 50 HP is not insubstantial, but I currently have over 1,000 HP, over 1,200. So it's nice, for sure. It's definitely not nothing. Over 200 of that is, if you recall, and I go back to the inventory screen, you can see 215 of that HP is coming from food bonus. So it's absolutely a thing that helps, right? And it matters, and it adds up. So this system allows them to be able to have these rewards, and it allows food to be more interesting. It encourages you to get all of the recipes, to get as much stat bonus from them as you can. But at the same time, it's not like the most pressing thing. Yeah, it helps, but it's not critical. You can get by without them. So it's this really good way of adding additional rewards for exploration, and additional rewards for exploration in the form of recipes as well as food or ingredients and such, without, like, severely punishing you for not doing it, if that makes sense. Like, I'd still be doing okay if I had, you know, 215 less HP and 15 less max MP and all that sort of stuff. I guess I'm getting a decent amount of defense from the con, but, you know, it helps. It definitely helps. But what I'm saying is that it's done a good job of allowing them to be able to spread rewards throughout the world that feel meaningful and feel like it's more than just a potion. Like, in Breath of the Wild, when you find new food, you're like, okay, well, this is just a potion, and it's whatever's most effective for what you're trying to accomplish. So maybe late game, you just cook a hearty thing. You're not worried about making fancy recipes because there's no benefit to it. Like, if you're in Breath of the Wild, you can make, you know, a cake or something. Or you could just make hearty mushrooms on a stick and get more benefit from that, right? So this system rewards you for going wide, making as many recipes as possible. But you can also just use it as a healing item, and it has that functionality too. So it allows them to add more healing items to the game, but it also allows them to add stat buffs to the game, and that stat buffs make it a more compelling, more interesting reward. And I think that's really interesting. I like the way that this game handles its crafting system overall, because I think it does a really good job of rewarding the player, allowing the player to be able to invest in expanding their capacity, their capability, in small slices, small increments, in a way that feels meaningful as well, however, a way that feels compelling. So I really enjoy that. I really think it's more interesting to increase my stats by cooking a wide variety of foods than just grinding levels. And you can grind levels to increase your stats. But cooking is a part of that, and it's an interesting part of it. And I really appreciate that. So I just wanted to talk some about it, talk about how this design works. I think it's a really cool way of doing it. It means that you can't just grind infinite stats by making, I don't know, say, a bunch of rice cakes, right? I can't just make a bunch of rice balls and get tons and tons and tons of max HP. It does give me a constitution bonus. That's cool. So, like, if I could just grind rice balls, I could make myself super tanky. But I can't do that. I just get a little bit from it. But I do get a little bit from it, and that's really cool. And that's what I love about this system. So that's kind of what I wanted to talk about. Just it adds a lot to the game, and I think that's really cool. And I would like to see more games experimenting with this idea of having rewards that can combine and make the system do more, if that makes sense. Make the system where, yes, I can make, say, a seafood curry as an excellent healing item, but I also want to at least make it, like, if I have a choice between seafood curry and pork curry, it's not just availability, not the first time. The first time, it's also, like, I'm not going to ignore making seafood curry at least once, because when I make seafood curry that first time, I get a bonus. And that makes getting the ingredients, like the Fournier's filet, that I need to make seafood curry, rewarding. And it means I want to go after different enemies, different parts of the map, to be able to make it. And I really like what that does. I really like how that incentivizes exploration, how it rewards exploration, how it makes finding new types of enemies engaging and interesting. And so I really like what they've done with the system in this game. So those are kind of my thoughts on it. And so I'm going to go ahead and wrap up here. And until next time, everyone, take care. And goodbye.